back. On April 3rd, 1973, Martin Cooper stood on 6th Avenue and 52nd Street in New York City with a device up to his ear and said, "I'm calling you from a cell phone, a real handheld portable cell phone." Cooper was 45 years old at the time, working for Motorola and a graduate of the Illinois Institute of Technology.
Today, the man who contributed to one of the biggest advances in human history remains optimistic about technology in our lives, and he's telling the story behind that phone in his book, Cutting the Cord, The Cell Phone Has Transformed Humanity. And we're thrilled to talk to him live. Martin, how are you?
Good morning.
I'm just great. Good morning, both of you.
I tell you, I'm astounded that this was 48 years ago that you made that first phone call. Can you believe it, looking back?
Well, it seems like yesterday today. I really would not like to admit that I'm 92 years old.
You look
fantastic.
You look great. And did you ever think that, I mean, even the technology we're talking to you on now is all related to what you did?
Well, Mary, we always knew, even back 45 years ago, that someday everybody would have a phone. Well, the story we told was that someday when you were born, you'd be assigned a phone number. If you didn't answer the phone, you had died. And we now have more phones than people in the world today, and more than two-thirds of the people on Earth have cell phones.
How is it that you became the guy? Was this something, an idea that you had that you thought was possible and you started tinkering, or did someone give you an assignment? How did it come about?
Well, it was really an adventure story, and that's the reason that I wrote the book. The Bell system, do you remember the Bell system?
Yeah, sure.
Where you couldn't even buy a phone, you had to rent it. And they're the ones that invented the idea of cellular, having cells in a city. But their concept was to have car phones. Could you imagine?
And we've been
tied by a wire to the wall of our kitchen for 120 years. Now they want to trap us in our cars. And that's what really stimulated this thing. We didn't believe that that cell phones should be a monopoly. And we didn't believe they ought to be car phones. We thought people ought to have the freedom to be anywhere when they communicated. So we took them on. It was a 13-year battle between Motorola and the Bell system, and guess who won?
Martin, I am just hoping that this is one of those stories that every time someone holds a cell phone, you're cashing a check.
Well, it didn't work out that way.
Does the money not go to you, or did it go to Motorola? I mean, does all of this come back to you somehow, I hope?
When I joined Motorola, they gave me $1 for all my intellectual property as long as I worked there.
What?
But I have to tell you, it was the best bargain that I've ever gotten. I had a great career. Motorola tolerated me for 29 years. I've had a number of industries that I got to help start. So it was a very rewarding experience.
Wow. Well, I think at least you'll be in the history books. I don't think anybody will remember who was president of Motorola at whatever point. Can I ask you, I saw a documentary where the guys who sort of created social media thought everything would be roses, everything would be fantastic, and they didn't realize the downside of social media and so forth. And is there a downside of cell phones? Are you seeing that? Do you think about that?
Well, you know, if you really think about it, the cell phone is not an old thing. We're still learning how to use it. And there are so many benefits, and that's one of the other reasons I wrote the book. There's so many benefits of the cell phone. It just swamps the bad side. And we're going to have three different revolutions within the next two or three decades in healthcare and education, and the whole idea of people working together. All those things are happening because we are connected. We have the freedom to be anywhere. We can collaborate. We can access all the information in the world. There are just so many benefits. To me, it just swamps the details of children sitting around with their heads on the cell phone. We'll figure that out.
I'm kind of overwhelmed by you because you have this philanthropic spirit about you, even though you did this wonderful thing that you really could have profited a ton about, but you kind of just gave it to everyone. I mean, IIT must be very proud of you.
Well, I'm very proud of IIT. It was a I knew from the time that I was aware that I was going to be an engineer, that I was going to go to IIT. And they were a superb school then, and they're getting better now. I actually am on the board of trustees of IIT now, and it's one of the top engineering schools in the country. We're lucky to have them in Chicago.
Well, it's so great to talk to you. The book, if you want to read more, is Cutting the Cord, and you can find Marty on his website and on Twitter.
Great to meet you.
Great to meet you.
Great to meet both of you.